Good afternoon, or good morning, or good evening, whatever time you're watching this. Welcome to Pastor Deborah and Friends Storytime. Yay! Let me begin by saying we are very sorry for skipping 1 week. It has been so busy, and my producer just got a job, so he has to go, but he's back. Yay! Uncle Coleman, welcome. So today, we will be talking about a young man named Daniel, and he's coming from the Word of God, the Bible, Daniel chapter 6. And the old chapter 6 talks about Daniel and how Daniel living in a strange land and dealing with strange people, yet Daniel was a believer in God and he kept to his faith. Daniel trusted God and Daniel always telling the truth. So today we are going to talk about Daniel. Let me put my Bible aside so that you can really see. I love Daniel because Daniel is a good example to every little girl and little boy, or young people and teenagers, that we can be who we are. We can be ourselves. We don't have to allow peer pressure to change who we are, because we are the identity of God. We have our identity in Christ Jesus. So Daniel is in the midst of people he never met, is in the midst of people he didn't know, but he kept his faith and he trusted in God. So long time ago, in a land far, far away, Daniel was taken captive to a foreign land and he became a slave. But because Daniel was diligent, he believed in God, he prayed to God, he began to live his lifestyle the way Daniel would have lived at home. So let me ask you a question. When mommy and daddy are not around, are you true to yourself? Am I true to myself? So King Darius, where Daniel was taken to in Babylon, the name of the king was King Darius. And King Darius noticed Daniel, and then he invited Daniel to be a leader in his kingdom. You see, Daniel did a better job than the other two leaders of any of the royal rulers. He was an unusually good and able man. But the other leaders tried to find something wrong with Daniel, with the way Daniel ran the government. But they were not able to.
Don't you think I thought of that?
Daniel never did anything wrong. Always on time, always true to his assignment, and always doing his assignment diligently. So the leaders ganged up against Daniel. Have you ever been in a situation that some people gang up on you? Hold your ground. Don't give in to do evil, because God is going to reward that. When you tell the truth all the time and when you trust God all the time, God will elevate you. God will lift you up. That's what the word elevation means. God will honor you. God will reward you for telling the truth and for being faithful. So these people, they ganged up against Daniel and they said to the king, "We have agreed that you should give another, your highness, and you should make sure it is obeyed, your highness. Why? Here is a command that you should give for the next 30 days. Don't let any of your people pray to anyone or any god or any man except you, king." You see, the king did not know that they were setting him up because they were bad. They think Daniel's righteousness was too much for them and they were going to just get rid of Daniel. And king, if these people do not pray to your name and to your name alone, we want to suggest that you throw them in the lion's den and the lion will eat them up. So they thought they have the best plan to get rid of Daniel. So some of the leaders who ganged up against Daniel and told lie about Daniel to the king were ready to see and get rid of Daniel. So some of the leaders saw Daniel praying and asking God for help. Let's stop right there. When things are not going well, when you are confused, when I'm confused, when I'm sad, when I feel people don't like me, who do I talk to? Do I talk to God and say, God, please help me? Or do I go to other friends and say, oh, let's be mean and bad to them also? No, we won't do that because we are children of God. So Daniel went to God and he asked God for help. So they went to the king. They said, hey, king, we got him, we got him, we got him. You know, we all agree that for the next 30 days, no one of your people could pray to any God or any man except you, the king. And the king said, yes, yes. Well, we found someone who was praying to another God, and his name is Daniel. And then, because we've all agreed that anybody that prayed to any other God outside of your name should be thrown into the lion's den. So you must arrest Daniel. You must arrest Daniel. The king answered, the order must still be obeyed. So Daniel was arrested. Daniel was thrown into the lion's den.
I would honor you.
Daniel still prays to his God 3 times a day. So the king gave the order. Daniel was brought out and thrown into the lion's den. The king said to him, you always serve your God. What a testimony. Can your friends say that to you? That we know that you are a Christian. You have Jesus in your heart. You will always tell us the truth. You will always trust God. I pray that your life will be a testimony like that. So if you always been truthful, King said to Daniel, I believe that your God will save you. So they took a big stone and rolled it into the lion's den and closed the mouth of the cave, thinking that as soon as Daniel landed in the lion's den, the lion will say, oh, nice lord, let's eat him all up. But something happened. As soon as Daniel was dropped into the cave, the lion couldn't do anything. The lion couldn't do anything because God sent his angels before Daniel got into the lion's den to close the mouth of the lion, and they could not do anything. Then in the morning, as soon as the sun began to rise, the king got up. He hurried to the lion's den. When he got there, he called out to Daniel, said, Daniel, are you there? You serve the living God.
Daniel.
As your God, being able to protect you from the mouth of the lion.
Speak to me, do you live?
Then he waited. Daniel. He waited. He waited. Will Daniel answer me? Or has he been eaten up by the lions? All of a sudden, Daniel said,
I lived right.
Your Highness, I am alive. My God sent his angels, and his angels shut the mouths of the lions. They haven't hurt me at all. That's because I haven't done anything wrong in God's sight. And king was very happy. And king said, roll away the stone. Roll away the stone. Daniel, come on, come on. It is true. You serve a great king. You serve a great God. And because of you, from today, the entire kingdom will serve the God of Daniel. And everybody was happy. But the king did something else. everyone who ganged up against Daniel. The king called them and said, "You bad leaders. Few weeks ago, you came up with a lie that whosoever did not pray to my name should be thrown into the den of lions. You were trying to get rid of Daniel." And the king said, "Arrest all of them, bind them, and put them into the lion's den." All of a sudden, they were arrested, bind their hands and feet, and they were thrown into the lion's den. And the lion had a feast. They ate them all up for ganging up against somebody who tells the truth. Now I want to tell you, don't join bad gangs. It never works. It never pays. Even if you're standing alone, always tell the truth. Always trust in God. The Bible says a righteous man fulfills his words even when it hurts. When we tell the truth, when we trust in God, some people might not like us, but I want you to know that God will respect you. Bad people, we will always be punished. So when your friends comes, when your friends come and they said, "Let's go hurt somebody," don't do it. Excuse me. "Let's go do bad thing," don't do it. Remember the life of Daniel and follow the life of Daniel. The Lord will bless us in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Father, we pray today that you will help us in our homes, in our schools. We are surrounded with some people that are just bad. Help us not to be part of them. Help us to remember the way Daniel lived. He was always telling the truth. He was always trusting in God. So Lord, we pray that you will help us to always tell the truth, to always trust you, to always believe in you. Thank you, Jehovah, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. So don't forget, this week, tell the truth. And begin to tell the truth for the rest of your life. And begin to trust in God. Thank you. Now I'm going to move to our story, because I would like to continue the story we started. And it's coming from why boys and girls are different. Why boys and girls are different. So today, we have two girls asking each other question. Have you ever asked your friend a question and then both of you were talking about it? Look at these two girls. They were asking, or a boy and a girl, they said, "How did God make us so that we can do so many things?" The other one says, "I don't know. Let's ask. Let's go and ask mommy and daddy." And then they ask mommy and daddy, "Mommy and daddy, how did God make us?" Mommy and daddy said, "God designed and created you in a very special way." You see, sometimes a grown-up boy and a grown-up girl love each other very much. They want to be together and help each other for the rest of their lives. They decide to be a family. So with God's blessings, they get married. Then they decide they want to have a little baby to share their love. Part of being a family is welcoming children into their lives. God planned that mommies and daddies are both needed for a new baby to be created. The baby grows inside its mother for 9 months. It is safe and warm in a womb. Remember, you are in your mommy's belly? Yes, yes, you are growing. Sometimes the baby wiggles and kicks, and mommy can feel it from outside. God is blessing this growing family. Oh, I think it's great. Me too. After 9 months, the baby is born. It comes through the mother's vagina, or sometimes they open mommy up and they bring the baby out. The whole family is very glad to see the new baby. God blesses us in an important way. He puts people in families. That's so they can take care of one another and always love one another. No matter what, it's a good thing to belong to a family. Some families are small, some families are big. There are many different kinds of families, and I thank God for my family. I hope you are thankful for your family, your brother, your sister, your mommy, your daddy. Let's thank God for your family too. End of this story. The Lord bless us mightily. So today, I invited new friends. Two new friends just joined us for our show. This is Dr. Goodbear. Dr. Goodbear, say hello.
Hello.
Yeah, thank you for coming to the show. And, oh, look at the red doggy. Hello, Sivanus. This is Sivanus. Hello, Sivanus. How are you? Welcome to Pastor Deborah and friends story time. So, thank you for joining us today, and we hope that you will come back. Oh, you want to stay? Yay! Thank you. Oh, so good to see you, Dr. Goodbear. I hope you won't have to treat coronavirus in our midst, but we're glad that we have a medical doctor on our team. Thank you. What about you? How can you help around the house? You can help mommy clean. You can help daddy clean. You can wash the dishes. You can make your own bed. You can help your brother or your sister. Because that's what family is all about. If you have any question, you know where to call, what number to call. Pastor Deborah and Friends Story Timeline 204-296-4501. Goodbye. Have a wonderful week. See you next time.